Hello, children. Welcome back to your English class. Today, we will read the poem The School Boy, written by William Blake. Before we start the poem, let's take a look on poet's journey. William Blake, he was born on 28th of November 1757 at Soho in London, that is United Kingdom. And he was died on 12th of August 1827 in London, United Kingdom. Children, I often say that before you start any prose or poetry, you should know something about the writer or the poet and his or her literary style. It will help you in understanding the chapter or the poem well. In this context, let us know William Blake's poetry style. William Blake was a romantic poet, and no, that doesn't mean that he wrote about love and all that cheesy stuff. A romantic writer was someone who believed that nature was the strongest and not man. They also had a dislike for the monarchy. One example of his work is the poem London. The poem emphasizes how the poor are suffering as well as everything being owned, even something thought to be as free as the River Thames. He also says how the deaths of countless soldiers are caused by the palace and monarchy. Now let's start our poem, The Schoolboy. The schoolboy in the poem is not a happy child. What makes him unhappy? Why does he compare himself to a bird that lives in a cage, or a plant that withers when it should blossom? I love to rise in a summer morn, when the birds sing on every tree, the distant huntsman winds his horn, and the skylark sings with me. Oh, what sweet company! Who is I in this stanza? I is the schoolboy. I love to rise means I am happy to get up. Huntsman, it means hunter. Winds, sounds by blowing. Horn, a sound instrument. Sweet, attractive. Now let's see the explanation of this stanza. Here in this stanza, schoolboy is saying that I like to rise from my bed in a summer morning. I find the birds singing on every tree. In the distance, I hear the sound of a horn blown by a hunter. Hunter means shikari. I like to sing with the skylark. And who is skylark? It is a bird. Schoolboy is saying that the morning seems to be full of pleasant company. But to go to school in a summer morn, oh, it drives all joy away. Under a cruel eye outworn, the little ones spend the day in sighing and dismay. First of all, let's see the meaning of difficult words. Drives all joy away means destroys all happiness. Cruel means unfeeling. Outworn means exhausted. Sighing means mourning. Dismay means disappointment. When the schoolboy goes to school in a summer morning, all his joy disappears. He has to spend the day under the supervision of a cruel teacher. He is sad and disappointed, feeling bored with the studies and the school. Then at times I drop in sit and spend many an anxious hour. Nor in my book can I take delight, nor sit in learning's power, worn through with the dreary shower. Dropping means to hang down as from exhaustion. Anxious means worried. Bower, arbor, worn, expressed. Dreary, cheerless, shower, shouting of words in rapid succession. The schoolboy bends exhaustively and takes a seat. He spends his day worriedly awaiting the end of the day. He does not find his books or studies interesting. The rainfall of words sounds dull and boring. How can the bird that is born for joy sit in a cage and sing? How can a child, when fears annoy, but droop his tender wing and forget his youthful spring? Annoy, bother, droop, hang down, tender, soft, youthful, young. The schoolboy wants to ask how a bird born for happiness can stay in a cage and sing. The bird wants freedom, but the imprisonment curtails his freedom as well as happiness he is entitled to. Likewise, a child who is always scared forgets his childlike innocence and activities and drops down his wings of freedom and joy. O father and mother, if birds are nipped and blossoms blown away, and if the tender plants are stripped of their joy in the springing day by sorrow and care's dismay, how shall the summer arise in joy or the summer fruits appear? Birds, shoots, nipped, plucked, blossoms, flowers, blown away, taken away by the wind, tender, delicate, stripped, deprived, springing day, day rise or early morning, dismay, dishearten. Now, in this last stanza, the boy speaks to his parents and informs them about important scenarios. He says, if birds are destroyed at an early stage of their development and not allowed to bloom, if the flowers are driven away by the strong wind, if branches and leaves are taken off their plants, the summer becomes joyless as well as the fruits don't grow anymore. He wants to say, if children are deprived of their childhood and innocence and dumped into the boring world of studies, their growth, physical as well as mental, gets affected. Before concluding, let's take a look on some important features of this poem. As you know, this poem is written by William Blake and from the perspective of a young boy who hates going to school in a disciplined way and rather desires to be like the birds. For him, the school is just like a prison, which does not allow the creativity of a person to flourish. The poem has been divided into six stanzas. The rhyming scheme of this poem is A, B, A, B, B. It is included in Blake's collections, The Song of Innocence. Thus, in this poem, the poet describes the innocent nature and desires of a young boy.